my talk is dear to my heart. It is facing democratized tech education in Africa with AI. Can we even democratize tech education with AI? Seems like a lofty feat. Can AI solve anything, let alone everything in Africa? There are two things to look at in this regard. One, can we solve for tech education access in Africa? And two, why should we solve for tech education access in Africa? Well, the reality is that Africa is in a tech industry deficit. We make up 17% of this population, yet less than 5% of us actually have advanced tech skills. That's an issue. But let me not get ahead of myself. Let me start at a gentle place, a simple place. I'm 6, and I've convinced my sister to run away from home. It's hot, and because we are who we are, we band together. She's cleverer than me, but incredibly impressionable to my ideas. My mom says I've always been able to sell a fish to a fish, and so I sell my pitch. I tell her we can do this. I tell her to take only one bike, because two is very suspicious. We make it to the gate and beyond, and we truly run back because of fear of my mother's mourning. Like 6-year-olds, I learn a lot there. I learn something so, so pure, that if you can convince someone something about themselves well before they know who they are, you've got them. You see, like 6-year-olds, we're incredibly impressionable. And those things, good or bad, they stick. Are we impressionable enough for new ideas? I'll ask this again. Are we impressionable enough for new ideas? I like to think of that as my introduction to the human nature, that we become increasingly less impressionable as we age. But what has that got to do with the tech professional crisis in Africa? Well, it has a lot to do with it. I think we need to get a new impression of who is worthy to enter tech roles. Truly. I think we need to lower the barriers to entry, that we truly need to democratize tech education. Do you think that the current education system has been quick to tell you whether or not you are worthy of a professional role? Even a tech role? I think it has. And I think that system, that broken system, can be beaten with AI. Because really, AI is just really good data put to work. For starters, we already know that Africa is flooded with the beautiful people. We choose to go together rather than alone, and we are incredibly resilient. But Africa is still at this deficit. We truly don't have enough tech professionals for the rate of our beautiful innovations. This is our crisis. You see, solving for African issues is not as simple as a 6-year-old's pitch to a sister. Because our past, it is fragmented in nature. We may need to curb our impressions about the education system and also about access. Because quick solutions do create bigger problems. The word solution to something as weighty as democratizing tech education, it's oversized. It almost seems impossible. How do you solve for lack of access? How do you solve for the bedrock of what makes for free and fair education? We have seen global solutions to African problems before. In 2015, the New York Times released a compelling story, read by very few. It told of the tale of the fishermen and fisherwomen in Zambia and Tanzania who were fishing Lake Tanganyika River. 10 years ago, they were brought to their knees in a horrible crisis. Flooded with malaria. The solution didn't seem too complex. Organizations banded together, sending thousands of malaria nets to a very ready environment. What happened was blatantly obvious to the people of that beautiful, beautiful community. Community after community banded together and turned those beautiful malaria nets into fishing nets. They had to choose whether to eat or whether to starve, and they chose neither. You see, we understand that sometimes we pilot our solutions through a different lens, and that often is a global lens. You see, the fish life ecosystem in that area took a hit, an almost demise. Why am I telling you this? There's one way to look at this in parallel to the way that we solve for solutions in Africa. You see, a lot of the time our solutions are conspired through a global lens. If we want to solve, we truly need to solve for our solutions through an African lens. What if we pulled apart the system and took what we needed? Our solutions need to be African-facing. How do we impact the 16-year-old boy who feels worthy of the tech professional role but has to jump through so many accessibility issues just to be deemed worthy of the space? You see, we built access on a concept of global. The assumption was, like global, that we had no time constraints. But remember, Africa's at a deficit. We should be looking for problem solvers. We created a biased entry process. Not biased because of background, but biased because we used a global test for affinity for tech. We should be looking for problem solvers because that is the key underlying thing in every single tech professional. We know how to solve problems. We instead looked at the maths grade and overall matric mark. But remember, Africa is at a deficit. What data has shown, and we know is true, is that the only thing that matters in a tech professional is the ability to solve problems. Whether you're a back-end developer, whether you're writing code for big startups, whether you're actually building beautiful interfaces for beautiful banks, you know how to do one thing: solve problems and solve them quickly. For 6 years, I was part of an app development company and launched an exciting pilot. I found a group of previously disadvantaged individuals in the lower income bracket of South Africa, Alex to be exact. They all did not have anything beyond their high school diploma. They had one thing in common: they knew how to solve problems. I built a game, a simple AI, built off Marshall's SAPS test. All it was looking for is, can this individual solve problems? They are still in tech today. What does this mean for us? It means that we need to do better as a country. It means that we need to be seeing individuals in different spaces and acquiring their knowledge into tech. It means that there are more tech professionals than we've actually counted for. And I'm not saying that we need to delete the game. I'm just saying we need to lower the barriers to entry. I'm not saying we need to burn the playing field. I'm just saying we need to change how we choose who gets to play. You see, we need to use an AI-led signifier for tech affinity. It's the only way to solve this problem, and it needs to be African-facing. Because like my 6-year-old self, if I can go with someone else, I definitely can go further. Thank you.